Hey, Satchel again. I'm still here. It's been like, I don't even know how long I've been here. It's been months now. Band's wondering where I am. Hopefully they won't replace me. A lot of guys want my gig. Not because it's easy, but because I get a lot of girls in Steel Panther. I know you already know that. I want to talk to you about one of my favorite songs off our new All You Can Eat record. This song is called Gangbang at the Old Folks Home. Something that I wrote about one of our singer's personal experiences when he was delivering pizza out in the San Fernando Valley. He had to deliver some pizzas to old folks home and some stuff happened. I know. But the good thing is, it turned out to be one of the best experiences of his life. And I used a rhythm guitar riff on it that I really, really dig. And, you know, one thing I like about it is that it makes me feel like I'm James Hetfield, because James Hetfield only uses downstrokes wherever he goes. Doesn't matter where he is. James Hetfield could be in the finest restaurant in Paris and he's still gonna use just downstrokes. You can't get him to use upstrokes.
Or he could be in a gangbang.
Whoa, what did you say? He could be at a gangbang and he wouldn't use upstrokes. He's just downstrokes. I don't know how you get out when you're just doing downstrokes, but listen, James, if it's good enough for James Hetfield, it's good enough for this dude, right? Because James Hetfield is an awesome rhythm guitar player. So I want to show you the rhythm guitar parts for Gangbang at the Old Folks Home right now. We'll see how well you do on it, all right? Kick it. Talk about this. It's all downstrokes, which I think is there's a reason why it's good enough for James Hetfield. Okay, James Hetfield doesn't use upstrokes. Well, you know what? He might use upstrokes when he's in the privacy of his own home, and I don't want to talk to him about that. But I'll tell you what, dude. When you're doing downstrokes, you're gonna get a lot more consistency with something like this. You know, it's very difficult. I mean, obviously, this tempo lends itself to all downstrokes. But those downstrokes are more consistent than even just the tone of an upstroke sounds different than a downstroke. No matter how hard you try to make an upstroke sound like a downstroke, it's not going to happen. But it's a good rhythm part to work on and to develop that consistency in your downstroke ability. Your downstroke ability. Downstroke ability, stroke ability. Your downstroke ability. That's what I'm trying to say. So work on that. It's good for you. You're gonna need those downstrokes when James Hetfield wants to finally hire another rhythm guitar player in Metallica. And you never know when that can happen, dude. You might just go, you know what? I got enough money. I'm going to do it. I'm going to hire somebody else to be the rhythm guitar player in Metallica. I want that kid, the 12-year-old kid that's been practicing his downstrokes all year. So check it out. The beat and the accent falls in a different place in the beat. It turns around throughout the bar on this. It's like a triplet feel over a 4-4 beat, which is why you need that metronome, guys. Go get the metronome. Start working with it. I'm telling you, one of these days you're going to call me, you're going to go, Satchel. And I'm going to be like, how the hell did you get my number, man? What the hell? And you're going to be like, dude, it's all over the internet. It's all over Twitter and Facebook. And I just wanted to thank you for the downstroke advice, because I'm the new rhythm guitar player in Metallica. And I'm going to be like, you're full of shit. And then you're going to hang up the phone on me. But you're going to want that metronome, guys. It keeps you grounded and lets you know exactly where you are. If you're ahead of the beat, if you're rushing, you're going to hear, you're going to fall off the metronome, and you're going to feel silly in front of all your friends. And ridicule is a great tool for musicianship. Okay? Make sure you work on those accents. Really dig into that accent. I'm doing all downstrokes on that riff too, on the descending blues pentatonic bass riff. And notice the way I mute it. It's pretty tight. So really work on your how aggressive you're being, and I think that's the more in control of your muting ability, the more aggressive you can sound. If you're not able to mute very well, it's harder to sound aggressive on the guitar. That's why James Hetfield sounds so good. I mean, it's like muted and very aggressive. I know you're thinking, what Metallica song was that? Well, I don't know, just making stuff up. That's what I do. I go, oh, you know what? Slayer, check out Slayer. What Slayer song was that? It's a new Slayer song, I just made it up. Okay, Slayer can have that one. But listen, those guys, they sound heavier, they sound more aggressive because they're muting, and a lot of it is downstrokes. So that's what I'm using here on Gangbang at the Old Folks Home, because if you ever need to be aggressive, let me tell you, it's at the Old Folks Home. Trust me. So this verse is pretty open on the guitar, and I let the bass and the drums carry it. But there's a couple cool little spots in here. I'm just basically playing the two notes, on the A and the D string. I'm doing like a perfect fourth interval, with the root being the fifth, and I've got the root being on top, and the fifth being below. So I'm going, so the bass is holding down E the whole time. And moving up the scale here. Little riff there. Then there's a part where the snare and the guitar hits. I hit these harmonics here at the third fret. And not always easy to hit on those babies, because they're easy here, they're easy here, they're easy here. But that third fret, you gotta get it right on. We'll be right back. So that's the verse. So basically the chorus is very, very open, and it uses but it uses some inversions of chords. I know that's a big word, inversion. Inversion. Have you ever heard that word before? Inversion. I'm basically doing a B power chord in the beginning. And then I'm doing an inversion of a G chord. Now, George Lynch would go like this. But I'm using an open string, and I'm using some notes on top here. So I'm basically playing a G chord with a third in the bass. Which I kind of like. It's pretty heavy metal. It's not a super common chord, though. But then I go to basic power chords there. This is where you need to be aggressive again. Really dig into it and work on that vibrato. Probably heard this chord before in songs like You Shook Me All Night Long. That's like a C add 9, I believe. Am I not right, Andy?
Sus 2.
Okay, sus 2. I was close. Add 9, sus 2. Isn't an add 9 and a sus 2 basically the same thing?
Yes.
Thank you. I got credit for that from the main man. So you got a C sus 2, like I said, C sus 2, right here, to end the chorus. I like the sus 2 chords, because they remind me of Rush. And I like all the chords that Rush did. Everything Alex Lifeson played was bitching. But anyway, back to our song. That's basically the whole chorus right there. That's all you need when you got three-part harmonies on a chorus like that. You don't want to get too busy sometimes.